On a souvent dit que CERN naît d'un désir commun de physiciens d'avoir des instruments de travail qui n'étaient plus à l'échelle d'un seul pays en Europe.
Monsieur Félix Bloch signe en qualité de directeur général de l'organisation sur un document qui devra permettre une poursuite exclusivement pacifique de la recherche scientifique.
Since its birth in 1954, CERN has been a pioneer in making the science, technology, and know-how produced by its scientists freely available to the world. The purely scientific nature of the research performed at CERN has attracted physicists from many nations, despite the political tensions between them. During the Cold War, CERN was one of the few places in the world where Western and Soviet scientists could work side by side. Following the ideals of its founders, the laboratory contributes to strengthening peace in Europe. It is the core values underpinning CERN's founding convention that made the laboratory's extraordinary scientific and technological achievements possible. An iconic example of CERN's impact is the birth of the World Wide Web in 1989.
But back in the 1980s, at CERN, it was an exciting place to be. Lots and lots of information systems on different computers, on different networks, all incompatible. So the idea was that one should be able to communicate by sharing information.
Today, CERN is a truly cosmopolitan laboratory, and knowledge sharing and international collaboration are upholding the laboratory's mission more than ever before. In 2023, more than 17,000 people around the world participated in the laboratory's activities with the common goal of pushing back the boundaries of knowledge. Throughout the year, the infrastructure and data collected at CERN were made accessible to over 12,000 scientific users, spanning over 950 institutions across more than 80 countries. Furthering this collaborative aspect, CERN actively supports inclusiveness and equality through a variety of initiatives. CERN's Diversity and Inclusion Program offers mentoring programs for early career researchers from underrepresented groups. The Women in Technology Program addresses gender disparities. The CERN in Society Foundation, celebrating its 10th anniversary this year, supports CERN's mission to share the benefits of science beyond the laboratory's gate, fostering creative synergies between science and culture. With Science Gateway, the new education and outreach center, over 1,000 visitors per day of all ages and backgrounds engage in the discoveries, science, and technologies of CERN, fulfilling CERN's vision for a world where science and learning are a part of a parcel of everyone's life. Aligned with its goal of promoting transparency, accessibility, and reproducibility in scientific research, CERN is committed to open science. The first international recommendation released by UNESCO to make scientific research from all fields accessible to everyone for the benefit of scientists and society as a whole. Keeping this goal in focus, CERN developed essential open services needed for conducting reusable and open research. Scope, the sponsoring consortium for open access publishing in particle physics, is a pioneer collaboration that has transformed the landscape of high energy physics journals into open access at no cost to authors. In 2013, the development of Zenodo allowed researchers from a variety of scientific disciplines to store data, papers, and software. Intended for use beyond the high-energy physics community, this free open repository has been a key player in the COVID-19 response, providing researchers with a platform to share trustworthy results and data on the pandemic. Hosted at CERN, Zenodo is used today by more than 8,000 research organizations all over the world. Since its inception in 1954, CERN has transcended national boundaries through the universal language of science. What began as a model to restore Europe's research capabilities has evolved into a global collaboration, setting a standard for international scientific partnership.